And welcome to this afternoon's game, live sports coverage by Channel V6, V6 Media. All of our sponsors bringing you this live coverage. I'm Mark Winterton, along with me, Brandon Jones, as we got Union Cougars taking on the Providence Hall here in baseball today.
The Patriots. Yeah, they even got the colors of the Tom Brady Patriots.
Yeah. Well, and this ought to be a fun game today. Union coming in. Where are they at ranked in state?
They're second in their region right now. They're doing really good. They've actually won their last 6 of 7, so they're hot right now, hitting well. I mean, their batting average is really good. I mean, they're almost a .300 as a team, and that's pretty good for this far along in the season.
Some things I've heard as far as the team goes is, you know, the few slumps here and there, and they've been able to come out of it, and now getting ready to start, state tournament's going to be next month at the 1st of May. And so let's talk a little bit about their rival today, or their opponent today.
Yeah, Providence Hall, they come from Harriman, Utah. And, you know, they're pretty similarly, you know, matched in this matchup today. And they're 4-4 in region, so they're fourth, you know, and they're only a couple games away and 8-9 overall. And so they have some really good hitters. Just watch for number one, Gentry Evans, already has a home run and a double this year. And then number two, Ben Morales, is a senior also and has a home run and a double. Two doubles as well. So look for those two guys, big heavy hitters on this side. And, you know, they also hit a pretty good batting average of a .299. So that's even a little bit better than Union with their whole batting average statistic.
Well, Providence Hall, they did get a couple of, I believe, transfers that helped this team out this year. I know Union last year. Of course, these games between both Providence Hall, American Leadership Union, not really a whole lot of competition, and so this Providence Hall team sounds like they're a little bit better than last year's team.
Yeah, it does seem that they have gotten better. I mean, and then talking about Union too, I mean, there's been some really good players on this team, like Kobe Gurr already has a home run, 5 doubles this year. Lincoln Labrum, not only hitting well, has 2 home runs, but pitching really well on the mound lately. And then Easton Rohr is a kind of clutch guy that just makes routine plays, just makes them look super easy when they would actually be pretty hard fielding those ones. And he's batting unbelievably with like 6 doubles on the year so far. And so Union's playing really well right now, and they know it, and they kind of play with that swagger, and you'll watch it today.
Well, and on the mound, yeah, it's going to be on the mound today will be Lincoln Labrum. But a lot of depth in this Union Cougar team as far as from the pitching mound. You know, they probably got 8 good pitchers that they can rely on, and so that'll be important as they head into state with the pitch rule.
Yeah, when they played UN a couple weeks ago, Nate Foote was on the mound and played exceptionally. And the more innings he got and the more pitch count that he got, the better he got. And he was trusted all the way up to about the 6th inning, and it had 120 pitches before they, you know, put Lincoln Labrum in to finish it off. But it was a great game, and he had a good one then.
Yeah, and then Foote played a lot of catcher. He has played a lot of catcher. They've got Gurr that stepped in last year and filled in that. But Foote was really only pitching in the JV games, and so I'm not sure if he pitched in any varsity games last year.
And Kobe Gurr, he's a large frame, and he can make that throw off his knees to second base. It gunned down a runner up in Uinta on that new turf field that Vernal has. And it was a thing of beauty. We had a couple web gems. Another one is Raiden Dietz, number 7 for Union. He makes awesome plays. Out in the field, he made this one diving grab that could have been on ESPN Sports Center last 2 weeks ago.
Well, he's definitely one of their exciting players out in out in the outfield. So we will get ready to get started here. Again, thanks to all of our sponsors, Basin I&E, Ashley Regional Medical Center, Jones Paint and Glass, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, Zions Bank, 7-Eleven Ranch Restaurant, all helping bring high school sports right here live on Channel V6 Media. Again, you can tune in to our broadcast after the game. It's of course recorded, and you can check that out. It's on YouTube, but you can also get on our YouTube channel or channelv6.com and watch the games anytime.
Yeah, they also have on the Roku channel where you can do it all the time. And I actually just got a Roku with my TV set up, and it is pretty awesome. You can just go to, you know, a live game or an old game and watch it.
That's actually how I go back and
how you listen. Study for these yeah. games a little bit.
Well, that or even critique myself, right? How did I sound?
What? You're perfect, Mark. What?
Let's just know that's far from that. But hey, it looks like Easton Rohr. I think he's going to be starting at second base. It almost looks like. I was trying to get an idea of where they've got this. Yep, Nate Foote's going to be at first. I think Rohr will be at second. And you got Caden Heider at shortstop. And then over at third base is, I think it's going to be, it's either Zach Foote or Dace Wilcox. I'm not sure which one there. Oh, it's going to be Zach Foote. That's who it's going to be.
Yeah, and he's hitting well right now. I mean, it has almost a .400 average. So they really like him at the plate and any way of getting to him in games. And he's really young, too. I mean, he's only a sophomore. And, you know, watching Matt Labrum, you know, a lot of this is the players, and they do really well. But, man, it comes from the head of the snake. Matt Labrum has these guys focused and makes them work in practice and has them believing right now for something special here at the end of the season.
Well, what a great coaching squad, too, the group that Union does have in head coach Matt Labrum. But then on top of that, you got your assistant coaches in Justin DeCall, Atlee Zipp, and Regan Hunsaker. I know, I think Hunsaker helped down at Central, what is it called? Eastern. It's Utah State
UVU?
University Eastern.
Oh, okay. I don't know that one.
It's in Price. It's in Price. You got Joe Arnold, CJ Nebaker, Clint Gardner, Ryan Oplenop, and Nate Adamson. Old Buck's helping, and all those guys. That's actually a lot of baseball knowledge.
That is. And you know, you mentioned Clinton Gardner. He's a really good hitter, and he teaches people to hit really well. And you can see the influence that all these coaches have on these kids. And, you know, they're playing on another level right now, and that's why. So it starts with the coaching and then making plays.
Well, that's the thing I remember about Clint in high school. He could hit the ball. I mean, he was one that he would have that. How far did he hit it? 500 feet? What? You know, he could hit the ball. Oplenop with his speed. And anyways, hopefully they've been able to coach these kids and relay their knowledge down to these high school boys. So
yeah, and he's all about hitting that ball on a certain place on the bat. You know, he came in. I work at Jones Paint and Glass. He came in to get a little bit of paint so they could put it on this one spot of the bat that they could hit every time. And so he's all about that placement, where that ball is and where it can go and what can control you can do.
Well, it's time for our national anthem, and so we will go to that.
Ladies and gentlemen.
They did it at the soccer
game. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you out to our baseball game. That last national anthem was for the soccer game. We'd like to have our own here. We'll do that as soon as the other team is finished with their warm-up. We'll have the teams line up, and we'll have Coach Jessica Parker, who is our head basketball coach and our head track coach, will be doing the national anthem for us here.
Do
you have lineups and stuff?
Doing a little warm-up. We get to see a little Providence Hall action.
Yeah, it looks like if the catcher is number 27, Rubel Hernandez, and let's see at number first. Let's see what his number is. So,
all right. So tell us the ones we want to be watching for here.
So I was telling you about Gentry Evans and Ben Morales.
All right. So Gentry is number. He's gonna be pitching tonight, right?
Okay.
I think.
Number one.
Oh no. He's not. He's gonna be at first. Gentry Evans is at first.
Okay.
So that's. I think.
I don't know why they have number 23 at first then, but let.
Is that who it is? I'm trying to look at numbers. Oh, he's number one. Gentry Evans is.
Yeah.
But he's the three spot.
He's at the three spot.
Which I think.
Oh, no, or five spot right here.
Oh, there's the position. Oh, I'm looking at this. That's just his batting lineup. Okay.
We'll get it.
We'll get it. There's so many numbers up here. Okay, position. Yeah, he's going to be, I think, what, like a third then?
Third, yeah.
Is that him?
There he is. There he's throwing is. It right yep. there.
All right, so Gentry Evans, he's one to watch for.
Mm-hmm. And then number two, Ben Morales. And right. He's the coach's son.
And he's looks like he's going to be shortstop.
Okay.
He's your shortstop there. Okay. So that's your other guy to watch for.
And then Taylor Marshall, number 23. He's on first.
He's first. Okay.
He's a great hitter. He has a 300 average, five doubles, one triple. So I think we'll have a good game. I think that both these teams hit really well. If you look at, you know, their statistics, how many hits both teams have as a team, both have 91.
And Nolan Beck will be the pitcher tonight for Providence Hall, or at least the starting pitcher. Nolan Beck, he's a senior. What do you know about Beck?
Nolan Beck, he's a good one, man. Yeah. Look his stats up real quick, but you know, like Nolan Ryan, he pitches five. He's five wins and two losses. So, and then he has one triple and one double. So he's a great player with a .417 average. So you know he might be one of the best.
So let's ask this question then. Do you know or do you have this in your stats? Who those wins come from?
I actually don't. Yeah, we'll have to look that one up.
Well, that's I guess that's just a question in my own, trying to wait out how good is this Providence Hall team this year, but watching them out here,
they're good enough for fourth in the region right now, and it's a pretty close race all the way up to first, but you know they're 4-4 and Union's 6-2, so only two games back of Union in region, and region Union overall 13-8. And you know, I mean, that's pretty good numbers.
All right, my guess comes that they've lost against Juab. Then two losses against Juab, two losses against Carbon. Is Carbon in third?
Yes.
Okay. So that's our guess then. Is this Providence Hall's pretty decent? Union, of course, two wins against Carbon. Both. I know the one game was fairly close until. Towards the end of the game, I think in the sixth inning, Union just went on a run and had a great time at bat and beat up on Carbon. So, obviously, the team to beat in this region is Juab. Both those games fairly close ones. And it's kind of almost a mind game for the Cougars now at this point. As Juab, it seems like in every sport, they're always close battles, whether it's football, whether it's basketball, or whether it's baseball, and it's almost a mental game for the Cougars.
For sure. And then also, you know, they had two games that were canceled last week that they didn't get to play, and, you know, baseball is all about rhythm, and you want to play a lot of games. It's kind of different with, you know, football where you have a whole week to practice and then you got one game at the end. Baseball has so many games. And it's just because you have to keep in rhythm, have to keep that bat going. So it'll be interesting to see if they have any kind of rust, you know, not playing those two games that got canceled coming into this game.
Yeah, yeah. And so, a little past time here, but I think we're about ready to get started. We'll see what...
Yeah, they said they were going to have a national anthem, and then they just... I think they're just giving time for
now,
Providence Hall to warm up a little bit.
So far, Channel V 6 Media has broadcasted two games this year. This is our third as Orem at Uinta and Union at Uinta. You can go and check those games out again on our site, channelv6.com, YouTube channel there, channelv6, or you can check it out on the Roku. It all comes up, past games, whatever it might be. And then, yeah, so you got today's game, and then May 7th, so in 2 weeks, we'll be broadcasting the Payson at Uinta game. Oh, and then actually, so next week, because of the canceled Fruita game of last week's, they're inputting the Judge Memorial game. So Judge will be here at UN or at Union, Judge at Union, and that one will actually be broadcast. So we got another Union game coming for you.
That one will be Tuesday at 3:30 at the same time.
Tuesday the 30th. Okay, so there's your info. It'll be Brandon and Merlin live coming to you then next Tuesday.
I mean, what outstanding weather we got today, too. I mean, just a little bit of a breeze. The sun is out, which hasn't been the case.
Hey, this is what makes baseball season so much fun.
So it's funny. We were at that UNA game, and it started out sunny and beautiful like this, and then it rained, and then it snowed like crazy, and then it got nice again. And so you got all the elements in one game. It was the icebreaker in Vernal.
You got a little cold, but then you also got hot, and you're like, now it's time to take off the coat. Maybe not quite.
So it looks like they're done and warmed up, and they're getting ready to go. We're going to roll some baseball action here on Channel V6.
Again, our game coverage all due to our amazing sponsors, Basin I&E, Ashley Regional Medical Center, Jones Paint and Glass, L&L Motor, Moon Lake Electric, Strata Networks, United, operated by SkyWest, Utah State University, U-Tribal Enterprises, Zions Bank, 7-Eleven Ranch Restaurant, and Petrotech. Those are our sponsors for today's coverage here between the Union Cougars and the Providence Hall Patriots. As we got the coaches meeting here at home plate. What actually happens between the coaches meeting?
So they just go over, you know, the rules or anything that they need to talk about with something new, and just the class. What's another word for the class that they do? The sportsmanship type conversation.
And so as they do that, they'll get ready for the national anthem, and so we'll go ahead and get ready for that.
Coach Jessica Parker, who will sing our national anthem for us today.
Having a few, I guess you could say, technical difficulties with the mic. It's not working. And who wants to sing a national anthem without the mic?
Yeah, not me. Well, maybe.
Well, I guess that depends on who's singing, right? You may sound wonderful out there. Or you may sound horrible, but nobody knows.
Yeah,
it all
like
sounds
just,
good.
They got to switch out the battery here, so.
See if they can get it fixed and we can get going.
Hey, it's not our fault, so that's good.
Ready for some baseball.
Mic check.
Oh, it looks like they got that mic going.
Mic check,
so.
I could hear it.
Yep.
All right, we are ready to go. So here is Jessica Parker for your national anthem. Or not. I heard him say mic check, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And then he gives it to her and it doesn't work. So is she going to come out here and sing it without it? I wonder if it's the distance. Where's she going? Is she going to come up here?
Yeah, maybe just have her come sing it here in the booth.
Now, one player, I was just curious, Colby Hyder's not playing this year, and I can see him actually out here in the stands, but his brother Caden is playing shortstop, and I'm wondering what Colby's, I know he was a designated runner a lot last year just because of his speed.
Yeah, Caden's a great baseball player, and he does really well in that shortstop position because he can catch anything like a fly trap in that area.
And so she's going to come up here to the booth and sing our national anthem.
It looks like we got a soccer game going on here in the background.
Yeah, must be. But what do they got, shirts and skins over there? Or is that just the color of the shirt looks like they're
skin? Yeah, it's like a yellow.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam? Sorry, I'll start over. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's regular, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Coach Parker,
and we're back. We do
technical
problems there, but we were able to finally get a national
nice
anthem sang there
here.
As
starting lineup.
They're going to announce our starting lineup.
Shortstop, Ben M, number two. Batting second.
Cougars will start out in the field.
Noah B, number 11. Batting third, number one.
And so our starting lineup for the Providence Hall Patriots.
Fourth, we have Taylor M, number 23.
Up first is
fifth, we have Number eight, Josh
Ben Morales. Batting number two is Nolan Beck, the pitcher. Number three, Gentry Evans. We're going to see him, I think, at third base, right? Number four, Taylor Marshall. Batting number fifth, batting fifth is Josh Boynton. Sixth, Rhett Wolfe. Seventh, going to be Jaden Lopez. Eighth, Chase Marshall. Ninth, Cam Toy. And for the Cougars on the pitcher's mound,
we have in center field, batting first, number seven.
That is
on the mound,
Lincoln Labrum.
Tonight, number two, Lincoln Labrum.
At first base is Nate Foote. Second base is going to be Easton Rohr. Third base, I think that's Zach Foote. Our left fielder, left fielder, I think, is going to be Rhett Nebaker. Center is Raiden Dietz, and right field is Braden Nebaker. And then our catcher, Kobe Gurr. As far as our batting lineup for the Cougars, Raiden Dietz will be first, Lincoln Labrum second, Easton Rohr third, Dace Wilcox, the designated hitter, will be fourth, Zach Foote fifth, Caden Hyder sixth. Oh, I missed Caden Hyder. He's our shortstop.
You don't want to miss him.
He's our shortstop. Seventh, Nate Foote, Kobe Gurr eighth, Braden Nebaker 10th, and Rhett Nebaker will be batting 10th. Ninth, 10th, there we go. And it looks like we are ready to go.
Yeah, and Matt Labrum, you know, he's ready and fired up. But, you know, his keys to the game is that pitchers attack the strike zone right away. So he wants Lincoln Labrum to throw fastballs and get ahead in the pitch count right away. Win the freebie war, you know, capitalize on those walk situation, those routine plays that are easy and should be made, make them, no errors, and attack, you know, mindset offense. They want to attack Providence Hall right off the bat, get three straight outs, and then get to batting.
My first pitch comes in outside. Ben Morales, the shortstop for Providence Hall, is our first batter. So here comes pitch number two. Down the middle, strike one.
And when you throw a wild pitch like that right at the very first, I mean, it's usually because you're standing too long, and they stood there for quite a while.
Yeah, there's a hit by Morales, a nice fielder there. grounder over to first, and the quick out for the Cougars.
Yeah, nice job by Zach Foote. Good grab and an easy throw to first. And those are those freebies that you're talking about. You just got to make the plays you're supposed to.
And so here is batter number two for the Patriots. So that one comes down the middle. That's
pitcher
strike
against
one.
Pitcher right here, Lincoln Labrum and Nolan Beck.
Yeah, they always wait for that first pitch. They want to see it come across. Are they going to give that one a strike, or is that one a little high? He's going to go ball one. So we'll ball one, strike one. We've got a 1-1 count here. That one.
Just a little
strike
bit outside, but it caught that corner. So a strike, nice.
So a 2-1 count, one ball, two strikes. And swing and a miss, he strikes him out.
And Lincoln Labrum throwing the heat right there to check him out.
Four pitches and, four pitches and a strikeout. Our batter number three, this is Gentry Evans. He's the third baseman. This guy is the one to watch, right?
Yeah, Gentry Evans is a great hitter. Got a lot of power. As you can see, he's got that, you know, he's not super tall, but he's got a large frame and has a really good swing.
That first pitch into the dirt. Easy for Evans to watch that one go. But that one's going to come across. Strike one. So a 1-1 count now here against Evans. It almost seems like they wait. They want that first strike. As Evans will swing on that one. That one coming right back at us.
Evans has a 406 batting average. So every time he gets up to the plate, he's either getting on base or getting a double or a hit. I mean, this kid can really hit.
Well, he's got a 1-2 count. He swings and misses, and a strikeout by Labrum and retires the batters. The Cougars get out of that one really quick, yeah, and they'll be up to bat.
Just what Matt Labrum wanted to start the game. Three batters up, three batters down.
Well, Basin I&E, one of our sponsors in today's game here, live coverage of high school sports here in the Basin. And, of course, you're watching today. It's the Union Cougars taking on Providence Hall. Basin I&E providing electrical instrumentation and calibration services for the oil and gas industry, as well as residential and commercial services. That's Basin I&E. At Jones Paint and Glass, they were founded in 1938, celebrating 80 years of business. Jones Paint and Glass is proud sponsors of the live local high school sports coverage right here on Channel V6. And also Zions Bank. Zions Bank, another one of our proud sponsors. They've got three locations in Uinta and Duchesne counties. Plus online and mobile services, Zions Bank offers convenience and stellar service. We haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. Just check out more at zionsbank.com. Again, this is Nolan Beck on the mound.
And he's got a pitcher's name to live up by, you know. Like, if you have a name Nolan, like Nolan Ryan, you got to be able to pitch.
I got to pitch, right? I got to be a pitcher if I'm Nolan. Well, we shall see how he does here as Raiden Dietz will be our first Cougar up to bat.
As you hear his walk-up music, Limp Bizkit, I haven't heard that in quite a while. That's like more of my realm, you know, in the 90s.
This is something you would walk
up
to.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, it's funny they didn't do any walk-up music last year, and so it's fun for them to bring that back. I'm going to hear some interesting ones here.
So. And Raiden Dietz, you know, he's super fast, and so, you know, that's why he's the very first batter up. They like to get him on base so that they can move him to second. Really steals well because he's so quick.
Well, the first one across for Beck was a ball one. And Dietz just a sophomore, started last year as a freshman. That one's going to come across. He's going to call that one a strike. Caught the corner there.
That was some good movement on the ball right there. It was in the middle of the zone, and then it looked like it was going to go outside, and it just hit that corner. Good breaking ball.
And a smack down center field. And Dietz will get one.
And another great play by the Union Cougars, getting everything they want so far, as Raiden Dietz gets to first.
It was a perfectly hit ball. Just right over second base, high enough that nobody was going to get it in the infield, and just fell before the center fielder could even come up on that.
And he's going to love that too, because he's been kind of struggling hitting lately, especially in this league. They have an American League where he's had like a 400 average, and he's only have like a 230 average here at Union Cougars. So he's looking to get both those averages up.
Well, Beck's first comes across, strike one against Labrum.
So kind of like an AAU circuit team, like basketball. A lot of these guys play on an American League where they play on weekends.
Trying to pick him off there, and Dietz slides back into first.
And we'll see how far Dietz.
Again, look at Beck check.
He led pretty far off the bag right there and was going to definitely go, but
well, the thing is,
off throw.
Well, Dietz was still going out when Beck looked to throw. Beck was like, no, you are not. As Dietz getting a really big lead here. Now here comes the pitch. A breaking ball, strike two. 0-2 count on Labrum.
And that is the pitch right there. You run to second, man. It slowed down. Perfect throw would have had to been made for Dietz.
There's the pitch. That one going to go into the dirt, and Dietz will just stay there at first. So a 1-2 count now on Labrum. you hate having to dig out of a hole once you've got two against you. You know, it's tough.
Yeah, it's so important to get ahead in the count, and like they're doing so far on the pitcher's mound and also
so again
batting.
Into the dirt. Yeah, so now a 2-2 count.
And you know Lincoln Labrum's not a guy that's going to chase either. He has really good vision, so you got to put it right there. He ain't going to swing at it.
And a breaking ball, and Labrum hits this one high to left field. That one's going to get over the left fielder. Dietz is going to come in, so Cougars will score. Labrum's going to stay at second. A nice double there.
And you got to see a little bit of Raiden Dietz's speed all the way from first to home without the throw even being made. I mean, he is quick.
Nice little RBI there for Labrum and a double. And that brings up Roar. Roar's been known for his power.
So that's the seventh double of the year for Lincoln Labrum. And like I said, his plate presence is so good because he has that vision to not swing. He just is patient and waits for that pitch.
And you talk about doubles. Roar, does he get, what does he have, like 11 on the year? Has he just barely.
Easton Roar has eight doubles.
Eight doubles. Did you see? He got a whole, he just barely touched that. You could hear it.
And like you said, this guy's been playing the very best, I think, this season for this Union team because he has a really, really ridiculous average and is a double king.
Well, he really wanted to reach for that one, but it was way outside. So a 1-1 count on Roar. Labrum at second. Beck brings a pitch, and that one a nice hop off the pitcher's mound. Will Roar get there? He got him.
Yeah, they got him. What a good throw. Kind of a sidearm throw, but right there.
Well, and it brings Roar in, or Labrum into scoring distance here.
Yeah, and the pitcher didn't, I mean, the first baseman didn't, Taylor Marshall didn't even have to really stretch that far for that play.
Up to bat, Dace
good throw.
Wilcox.
Well, Dace Wilcox is our next batter for the Cougars. Wilcox, a junior for the Cougars. And that first pitch, that one looked like it was down the middle, but a little high, ball one.
And Wilcox already has a triple and a double this year. Looks to add on that on this play.
And he gets that one. A nice piece of it. Right fielder's able to come in and get it, and he'll keep Wilcox at first. But Labrum scores easily from third base there.
And already so far, just good patience presence at the plate, waiting for their pitch, and then just gets solid contact. As some of these walk-up songs, Mark Winterton's looking at me here. I'm a gummy bear? Okay.
This is Zach Foote. Zach Foote up to bat. Hey, I liked it.
Okay.
I liked it.
Yeah, I like gummy bears too, you know.
Beck tries to pick off Wilcox there at first. Wilcox, his long frame, he's not worried about getting out there and getting a little distance. He can fall right back onto the bag. Beck's going to bring the pitch outside, ball one.
Yeah, and just so far, you know, not a great rhythm here for Nolan so far, Nolan Beck. But he's a good pitcher, and he's going to figure it out. He's just try to get a little bit looser and try to find that strike zone a little bit better.
Well, they got one out here against the Cougars. Trying to pick off Wilcox there.
He's got a quick move to throw to first, and so it looks like that, you know, Union has scouted him a little bit because they haven't even tried to attempt a steal quite yet.
No, and I thought Dietz.
Yeah, I thought Dietz would go.
Was going to, but yeah. You know what's fun is when you get those left-handed pitchers that it looks like they're winding up, and now they're throwing first. Those are the ones that are tough to steal on. Another bad thrown ball there. That's going to be give Foote a 2-1 count. This is Zach Foote, younger brother of Nate. Zach is just a sophomore for the Cougars. As there's a pitch, another outside, and there goes Wilcox. He'll get an easy steal. as the catcher just lost control of that one.
Yeah, he was kind of fumbling it around, trying to get that throw to second, just couldn't do it, and stand up steal there for Wilcox.
So a 3-1 count now here for Foot. There, that one comes in, and he's going to take his base as that one came in high. Our next batter up, that's going to be Caden Hyder, shortstop for the Cougars. Trying to listen to his walk-up music.
That one I don't recognize.
Yeah, that's more actually today's
music. Yeah.
It's fun though when the others pick songs that are from our era, right? Yeah,
there you go. You need a what was that, 70s? For you.
Right. Hyder swinging on the first one.
Just kidding, man. 80s for sure.
That first pitch goes foul against the back net here. So just one out again.
Caden's definitely got the hair for baseball.
Oh, I think there's a few of them out there that do. Swinging, he's going to dig for that one. But going to come up short, so an 0-2 count now on Hyder. We'll see if he can come out of this hole. Or we'll see if he can just knock the heck out of the ball. With two runners, Wilcox and Foot at first and second. There's the pitch. And he pops this one up. This one's going to land right on us.
Really close.
Just as long as it doesn't hit my car.
I parked far enough away. I don't think I can get hit. But
that's probably one of the most things I'm paranoid. I can't. I'm stunned, actually, at the cars that are parked.
I know. It's funny when you come to a game and you say, oh, there's an open spot right there. You know, like, oh, that's like danger zone. Nope, not parking there.
You're definitely going to get hit. And Caden hits this one, a ground ball to the shortstop. Morales trying to make the double play.
He didn't get him at second. No, safe.
So we've got bases loaded with Nate Foot. And that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, AC/DC, your realm, man. I like this stuff too, man. AC/DC, Back in Black.
Little classic rock for you.
Thunderstruck, bases juiced. Let's see if he can grand slam this one home.
Hey, wouldn't that be fun? That's like everybody. That's a baseball player's dream.
Up to bat, Nate Foot.
And so, first pitch. Right down the line, Foot's going to take the hit. And we got a tag up at third. And here comes the runner.
Close play at third. Good slide.
Wilcox makes the gets home. And Foot, Zach Foot, gets to third. So we got runners now at the corners. But a great RBI there for Nate Foot. As that brings in a runner. And so the Cougars leading this one right now. Are we already fourth? Four? I'm trying to think who's come in. Lincoln came in. Raiden came in.
Are you saying that we've already done the batting order?
Dace Wilcox
this
came in.
This is the last guy. So
isn't it
3-0, Kobe Gurr.
3-0, and now what's up?
So 3-0, yep.
Did I just miss something?
I have no idea. So a timeout or something's been called on the field.
Oh, I'm like, there was no. Yeah, it's 3-0.
Or did they say that was the third out?
No, it was only the second out.
Well, what the heck is going on?
Is that what they're saying? He's like, there was three outs. No,
yeah, because Union's going out to the field, man. Like,
well, I'm wondering.
Or did they make the play at third? Or was there base interference somewhere? I didn't see anything.
I have no idea. You got me. Tell one of our – go find out what's going on. So at least we –
saw the field say out, but that's all I think he's at second. No one was at second. I just saw him go out, and I was like, what's out?
He must have not tagged up.
Oh, okay.
So they're saying that Foot actually didn't tag up completely, or maybe didn't wait until the ball was caught and then take off.
So then they just had to throw the ball to second, and there was
the
third out.
Yeah, so there was the out. Well.
So then that other score didn't count then. So it's
3-0. Yep. 3-0 is our score here. As, again, Our game brought to you today by Strata Networks. Strata Networks brings you more local cell sites than any other wireless provider. You can join the network with the best local coverage today and get up to $500 in credits with a qualifying trade-in. Just visit stratanetworks.com to learn more. Also, our game brought to you by Utah State University. You can be an Aggie in the Unibasin. No matter where you attend your diploma, we'll have the same three renowned words. Utah State University. Visit unibasin.usu.edu for more information or call 435-722-1700. 1700 to get started. And also, the 7-Eleven Ranch Restaurant. 7-Eleven Ranch Restaurant is a proud sponsor of both Uinta and Union baseball games here in the Uinta Basin. As here is pitch one for Labrum. Strike one.
Taylor Marshall at the plate. Senior has one triple and five doubles on the year. Let's see if he can add to that total and get one here on Lincoln Labrum.
That pitch came in a little high, so a ball one. Outside ball two.
And so far, Lincoln Labrum's just been throwing, you know, pretty much fastballs. Hasn't been really hiding anything. A little bit of break if he has a curveball, but he's really got that fastball going.
And why not? Strike two.
If it's working, throw it all day long, man.
Kobe Gurr doing a good job here at the plate, too, a catcher for the Cougars. That one, foul ball. Marshall getting a hold of it, just got a piece of it. That one was weird how it fouled. It almost fouled off the bottom, didn't it?
Yeah. And then it bounced off there.
Yeah. Yeah, fouled off the bottom of the bat. You don't see that much. That one right inside. Strike three.
And, you know, like I was saying, he's throwing fastballs pretty much the whole time. And then he threw that breaking ball right there. He put that changeup, slowed it down.
That's his third strikeout for the game.
That was a sick pitch.
And so Josh, this is Josh Boynton. Strike one. Josh Boynton, a sophomore for the Patriots. Outside, ball one. So a 1-1 count here. And that one, kind of a weird hop there. Yes, nice catch and throw there by Rohr. And foot, making sure he keeps his foot on the bag, reaches out for that one. So they get the second out.
Yeah, and Rohr, he's got an arm right there. That's a hard play to make if you don't have an arm right there. You have to really throw that one fast.
Well, and the accuracy.
Yeah, the accuracy. And accurate. You can see it on the replay, and a good stretch.
Love the L&L replay there. Labrum brings this one inside. He's going to swing on it.
Man, he is bringing the heat today.
This is Rhett Wolfie, just a freshman for the Providence Hall Patriots. He's got good size, doesn't he?
Big he freshman. He does, man. Big dude.
Usually it means he gets a bigger strike zone. That's tough for a freshman.
He's got three doubles on the year, a .283 average. So, I mean, he's got some things to learn, but he has a pretty good average.
For he's a already in trouble on this one against Labrum. 0-2 count here. Two outs. Cougars up 3-0 here in the top of the first. Top of the second. And that is strike out number four for Labrum.
And definitely got to keep track of his strikeouts today because he's on number four in the second inning.
That was really quite quick, was it not? That one went down really fast. And we're going to go to a quick commercial. We'll be back after this.
The Obstetrics Unit at the Ashley Regional Women's Center offers outstanding care for moms and their babies. before, during, and after the delivery. Learn more at ashleyregional.com.
I decided to attend USU Uintah Basin because I could stay here and keep doing what I was doing and be around my family and still be able to get the degree that I wanted.
It was important for me to stay in Vernog while taking classes and getting my degree because this is where my family is at.
Such a great opportunity that we have here in the Uintah Basin. There's great scholarships, there's great programs, it's such an amazing campus. The instructors care about you, and having that degree has opened so many doors. It's just an opportunity you don't want to pass up.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
And we are back as it is the bottom of the second here with the Union Cougars, Providence Hall Patriots. The Cougars lead 3-0. Kobe Gurr up to bat. Ball one on that first pitch. Second pitch going to come across inside. I think that's going to be ball two high and inside.
And when I was watching Nolan Beck, you know, and they were up to bat, he was out there kind of working his arm, trying to loosen it up and trying to throw – not with a catcher, but just loosening his arm enough to get that in rhythm again.
As Gurr's going to take this one right between the center fielder and the left fielder. He'll make a double out of this one.
So the bats have been alive for the Union Cougars today. As you see some celebration on second base as the pinch runner comes in.
Gurr's going to bring in pinch runner. That is number 23, Keyston Young.
And Young. Not too many baseball players, 6'6 in high school, but Keyston Young does a really good job out there. He can actually hit the ball really well, too.
But not only that, he's a decent pitcher, too.
Oh, yeah, for the absolutely. Cougars. And when you have tall guys like that that are pitchers, like, you know, who's that guy from Randy Johnson? They're awesome.
Young, just a sophomore too. Am I right?
I think he's a junior.
Is he a junior?
Yep, junior.
Oh, he is a junior.
Yeah, that's well,
and
good
a bunt by Braden Ebeker in between the third baseman and the shortstop.
Perfect bunt right there. Got every kind of hop you wanted. And almost impossible to field. So he was safe at first. The guy's safe at third.
And the Cougars back at the top of the batting order here.
Ducks on the pond. No outs.
So Raiden Dietz.
And Raiden Dietz is going to keep rolling here. With the Limp Bizkit soundtrack.
Base runners at the corners. Pitch comes in. And there goes Nebeker, and he's going to go ahead and steal second pretty easily. The catcher didn't even throw it. He just kept a hold of it.
Yeah, they had a guy on third already leading off. I mean, if you would have made a wrong throw or even too far to the right, that guy goes home. So good smart play by the catcher not to chuck that ball to second.
Well, no, neither second base or shortstop looked like they were ready for it as Dietz swings on that one hard. So a 1-1 count now on Dietz.
That's a good steal, too, because now you don't have that double play threat. Takes a little pressure off Dietz as he's batting. So that whole right
and
side.
And he's going to knock this one towards center field. Center fielder is going to get under it. They will tag up, and Keyston will come in for a score for the Cougars. So a 4-0 score. Cougars on top.
And Keyston Young in playing basketball this year, I said it in my last broadcast, I haven't seen a guy improve the way he did from the beginning of the year to the end of the year with basketball. And he's doing the same thing here in baseball. I've been watching him, and he's just getting more comfortable.
Labrum, number two on the batting order with a runner at third. Beck's pitch comes across, looks like it's going to be high. So ball one.
And, you know, Nolan Beck, he ain't throwing bad this inning so far. I mean, he's been throwing some pretty good pitches. But, you know, when hitters have your number, they have your number. And Union's hitting well today, and they want to keep going.
Ball two. Just one out. Nebaker at third for the Cougars. There's Beck's pitch and another ball. So now Beck finds himself in a hole.
And that's when he's kind of got in trouble. When he's gotten a hole like that, you have to throw that pitch over the middle. And then Lincoln Labrum, just so patient, knows when that's going to come. So he knows it's a payoff pitch.
That one's going to
catch the corner. That one goes right across, yeah.
Yeah, just catches the corner there. So 3-1 count now. Ew.
That's definitely your car.
No, I don't think it'll make it far enough. Okay. I'm parked across the street.
When you hear the crash.
Think of Jones Pane and Glass. Oh, that's a good one. Labrum with a full count here. And he's going to swing on this one. This one. I didn't see where it landed, but that was another damage done, right?
Labrum doing a good job again with that vision and keeping alive by hitting those foul balls, staying in there. Not only that, just adding to the pitch count of Nolan Beck up on the mound.
Oh, Beck's going to look for his sign. He's got it. He's got what he wants. Here comes the pitch inside, and Labrum will take his base. So he gets out of that one. had an 0-3 count. Turned it quickly into a full count. And he'll just hang on and take his base as Roar is up with runners at the corners. Roar, a senior for the Cougars.
What's that? Easton Roar.
With the walk-up song of the Beastie Boys, Intergalactic Planetary. Whoa.
That one's going.
Scared me.
I know. I saw you duck. I saw you duck. You saw that ball coming right back at you. As goes for the pick.
Ooh, that one was
close. I gotta
say
safe.
Yeah, close there, but good dive by Labrum. Pretty accurate throws from, you know, the pitcher mound to the first base, though. This Nolan.
Yeah, Beck's done a good job. He's going to try to pick off Labrum again. Yeah, he has. He's done a really good job.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I've seen any overthrows or mishandled throws. As Roar is going to put this one right through the opening, and they'll bring in a runner. Braden Nebaker adds to the Cougar lead, 5-0 here in the bottom of the second. We just in the bottom of the second? Seems like we're almost in. Cougars have gone through their batting order.
Yeah, they've been through their batting order a couple times. You know,
going through it the second time, I guess. Here is Dace Wilcox, their designated hitter. Up to bat,
Dace Wilcox.
Once we get to Kobe Gurr again, that will be the second time.
I thought he lost that one. I didn't see it. I didn't see him catch it. He was able to dig it out of the dirt.
Good little snag there.
Yeah, you got it. That's the thing. Important thing for a catcher. You got to get in front of that. Keep the runners at bay. Labrum at second. Roar at first.
And we got a guy.
And there's a steal. And he misses. Labrum's going to stay there at third. Steal from second to third, and of course after that was actually a mishandled throw by Evans. Gentry Evans.
Yeah, he had to come off the bat a little bit, you know, and it was a little bit off thrown by the catcher, but should have been made.
And so of course Roar's able to steal second, and so now gives him a little breathing room there. as there's a hit by Wilcox, goes straight to the second baseman. They'll put it in, two outs, but Labrum scores 6-0 for the Cougars. You know what that means?
It means Zach Foot is up at the plate,
that,
man.
Zach Foot.
Who hit a double last inning.
See, I would play, I mean, if I was a little bit of a fat kid, that's a song I've that's why I think of that. I'm like, I don't But Zach isn't that, so that's why that one's an interesting one. Was he known as that when he was younger? Is there a story behind it?
I don't know. We need to find out, I guess. Maybe it's his favorite, you know, snack. You got the beast mode with the Skittles.
Oh,
you got Zach Foot with the gummy bears.
The gummy bears. That's it. You are what you eat. Here's Beck's pitch outside. That's going to be ball three.
Marshawn Lynch. That guy was a beast.
Again, finds himself in a hole here. We'll see if Beck can get himself out of it. A 3-0 count here.
Is he going to play this year? I don't even know. Like, he played for the Raiders, yeah.
That one down the middle. I think that's – nope. I couldn't tell. Was that one low? And catcher wants to talk with his pitcher as that puts the Cougars at the corners here with Hyder at bat.
Yeah, Caden Hyder with the hair, the Chris McCutcheon's Pittsburgh haircut, man. Like it.
It's a baseball haircut,
Pittsburgh,
isn't
Pirates.
It?
And he even got the, you know, the white and the yellow going on. McCutcheon's great player.
So Beck takes a look at his runners. Here comes the pitch outside. That's going to be ball one. Hyder quickly to tell Rohr, stay there. Don't come in yet. So far, three runs in the first, three runs in the second as Beck goes for the pick. Just keeping Foot at first. That doesn't that didn't scare Foot at all. He comes off with a big lead. There's strike one on Hyder.
And, you know, that conversation between the catcher and the pitcher, I mean, that helps a lot. And then he's like, all you got to do is just get one and we're out of this inning, man. So he's just going to focus on this one batter. Who cares about everybody else?
Ooh. Hyder's going to reach for this one. It's going to go left field. Fielder able to come away with that one and saves the day. Well, saves the inning. The Cougars still got three out of it. 6-0 is our lead, and that's the end of two. We're going to go to a quick break.
I decided to attend USU Uintah-Basin because I could stay here and keep doing what I was doing and be around my family and still be able to get the degree that I wanted.
It was important for me to stay in Vernald while taking classes and getting my degree because this is where my family's at.
Such a great opportunity that we have here in the Uintah Basin. There's great scholarships, there's great programs, it's such an amazing campus. The instructors care about you, and having that degree has opened so many doors. It's just an opportunity you don't want to pass up.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Here at Stewart's Marketplace, we are pleased to announce that we are now carrying certified Angus beef. Team that up with our Smithfield Prime Pork, and Stewart's Marketplace has the best beef in the basin. So come on over and check it out. It's a cut above the rest.
And you're back. Welcome to, again, today's coverage. Welcome back to today's coverage here on Channel V6. It's Union Cougars taking on the Providence Hall Patriots. I'm Mark Winterton. Brandon Jones also here in the booth with me as Cougars back out on the mound, out in the field here to start the third inning. Jaden Lopez up to bat for Providence Hall. There's strike one. And it looked like Providence Hall won a little short timeout there.
Yeah, another crazy thing is that Lincoln Labrum's only at 25 pitches. I mean, that's so efficient with how far we are into the game already.
Really? Yeah, he's getting 12 pitches an inning. Strike him out, we're done.
And how many has he got? Four strikeouts? Is that what we have?
Yeah, he has four strikeouts so far. We'll see if he can get another one here against Lopez. He's got a 1-2 count already on Lopez. Pitch number four. And that one's high.
That's going to hit right on the top of our roof.
You think?
Nope. Close.
I was still waiting for it to hit. It was high. Straight back at us. So still just a 1-2 count. This will be pitch number five here for Labrum. But, yeah, he is 12 pitches in the inning, and that one in the dirt. So it'll be ball two.
And I'm not – have they even got a hit yet? He's pitching a no-hitter so far.
No, they haven't got on base, have they?
And another strikeout for Lincoln Labrum.
Wow.
Number five.
Wow.
Up to bat, number three, Chase M.
That one down the middle, strike one.
And right now, you know, you have Chase Marshall up. I mean, he's a speed guy. Might be a good idea to just to try to get him on base, maybe bunt here to the left and take off for the first. As they have him swing away on that one, he gets some contact, but it is foul. And Lincoln Labrum, he's got that fastball going, and so it's a tough one to hit, man. He's so ahead that when they're swinging so behind, it's foul ball or nothing. Foul ball or strike. And right now, I would throw a fastball right down the middle.
And he does. Strikes him out.
Yeah, that's what I did. I pitched and stuff like that, and you get a swagger going on like that. You just want to finish a guy off with a fastball, as he did right there.
Yeah, six strikeouts here.
Up to bat, number 12, of course.
That was Chase Marshall, who just got struck out. Cam Toy is our next batter for Providence Hall. Swing and a miss. Cam is the outfielder, I believe. Right field. Plays right field for the Patriots. I'm going to be outside. So a 1-1 count here on Toy.
Six strikeouts now for Labrum. Whoa, that one is definitely hitting a vehicle.
I don't know. It may have just gone into the street. What would be horrible is if you're driving the street and the ball right through your windshield.
I think I've seen like YouTube videos where they like hit a home run and it goes right through the side of a window. That would be a rude awakening. I did get hit with a golf ball in Park City, though.
Labrum thought that one was a strike. I think that one must have come in just a little too low for the ump to call that a strike. So a 2-2 count now here on Toy. As here comes the pitch. And Toy will swing again.
So can you imagine that? You're in Park City. You're on the freeway. You're pretty safe, but you get hit in the side window with a golf ball, you know, right where your kid's seat is, and it just shatters, and you think it.
That would be the worst.
You wouldn't have any idea. It was awful.
Who did this happen to?
Me.
What? Are you serious?
In Park City, yes.
That had to be a little bit of a surprise, right?
Yeah.
I mean, what did you think it was?
I have no idea. A rock? A gunshot? I don't know.
And you found the golf ball or what?
Yeah.
Like. And you're like, that's not random?
Yeah, it's right there by Jeremy Ranch, so there's a golf course.
Oh, my goodness.
But that's a pretty good shot.
That's a great – oh, that went off a Gurr's helmet. So we got a full count. The ump's going to come out – he wanted a little bit of a break. I think he was given the – you know what? when a pitcher does a good job, he gives him a little bit of a break.
That's right.
Like, you know what? I'll give you a break. I'm going to walk this one out to you.
Yeah, and so far he's been perfect. Perfect game so far. So you keep going with this guy. See if
you don't talk about
no-hitter.
That. You don't talk about those things.
You don't talk about no-hitters in
no.
third innings.
No, you stop that. And he struck
Holy
him out.
Cow, seven
he
Ks.
Thought he had it. He thought he was getting that one. And he struck him out. So how many? Seven?
Seven.
Seven strikeouts as the Cougars retire the Patriots there. Yeah, they'll come up to bat. So, wow, yeah. Great inning there for the Cougars. And, of course, your live coverage of high school sports here in the Basin, brought to you by Basin I&E, reliable and professional electrical contractors, bringing unparalleled service to your project. Also, Ashley Regional Medical Center is another one of our sponsors. Ashley Regional welcomes Dr. Tyler Moore, orthopedic surgeon. Dr. Moore did an additional fellowship, year-long special training in sports medicine, and he's been tending to patients since August. Also, Zions Bank. We haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. Three locations in Uinta and Duchesne counties, plus online and mobile services. Zions Bank offers convenience and stellar service. Again, yeah, we haven't forgotten who keeps us in business. More at zionsbank.com. As our first batter here for the Cougars will be Nate Foote. Nolan Beck still on the mound here in the bottom as we start the bottom of the third. The Cougars lead 6-0. We'll see if they can continue that lead, extend it here as Foote comes up with his walk up. A little AC/DC Thunderstruck. I bet his dad picked that one. Maybe not.
Maybe.
Some old school.
AC/DC is pretty
a little
awesome.
Old school. Actually,
I think every year in Prodigy likes, you know, AC/DC.
I actually think probably the call probably picked that one for him. Get a little help from the coaches. That one high.
That one should be caught.
Should be. It's in the sun, and they miss it.
Miss
and
it.
They miss it. Foote's going to go to second, and he's going to get tagged out. Did he make it? He's safe. What
wow.
a double.
Yeah,
I guess
that was.
You can't call it a double, can you? On an error.
Yeah, just some miscommunication right there with the pop fly. Just not calling it in time. If you look at the replay, it's like, is it you? Is it me? You got it. I got it. And then kind of lost it in the sun at the last moment. And that's what happens.
Kobe Gurr. With the Killers. Kobe, you're a star. Let's see what you got here. That one, swing and a miss right on the first pitch. That one down the middle for Beck.
Yeah, he was swinging for the fence on that one. Almost Maybe fell gotta, down after he
you
swung
You got
to
swing
one.
On that one. That one was a pitch right down the middle. He gets a hold. Just barely gets that one. It's going to go foul. And so we've got an 0-2 count on Gurr.
And that's probably one of the first batters that Nolan Beck has been ahead on. And so let's see if he can try to finish him off here. And you can afford to throw this one outside if you're Beck. I mean, you don't want to put it right there where he wants it. Make him chase just a little bit. See what you can do on this play. See how long you can extend him out.
Gurr, a junior for the Cougars, started last year as a sophomore. Played a lot of catcher. For the Cougars. Him and Foote actually kind of went back and forth at catcher. That's a breaking ball, and he is going to find the – must have been outside there. So a 1-2 count here for Gurr. Gurr's going to swing on this one.
Oh, wow, what a catch.
Play. What a play by that's Morales. comes up with the catch there.
Wow. Good awareness by, you know, is that Easton Rohr up on second?
That's Foot.
Oh, Foot. Because he was watching the ball as that got hit and caught. If, I mean, sometimes you're just going to go on that play because it's right up the middle. And he stayed there and didn't get out. So good awareness.
Up to bat, number 19.
Braden Ebeker, the left-hander. Oh, he's looking to bunt. And he bunted last time, got on base.
Oh, that's right. He had a great bunt, too. I mean, it went right to that shortstop position. He had a couple great bounces.
Yeah, he was able to advance the runner from second to third. It was Keyston Young, I think.
Yeah.
And there's another bunt. Pitcher can't get a hold of it. Third base can't get a hold of it. And Foot was thinking maybe run home, but...
And the ball splits the double team right there and gets away again, and Braden's safe at first. Everybody's safe.
Well, he's doing a good job with the bunting action. Mm-hmm. And that brings us back to the top of the batting order. It's Raiden Dietz, the sophomore, up to bat for the Cougars. Cougars have a 6-0 lead. No runs earned this this Raiden inning yet. But runners at the corners. There's Beck's pitch. That one looks like strike one.
And Union's done a great job of, you know, having people on base and getting them home today. I mean, they haven't left any, you know, many batters stranded at all.
I got to give props to the ump down here. Gives great signals. I can't stand it when an ump doesn't properly show a strike. And a strike two. And Nebeker just runs. He'll just steal second. No problem at all.
No one even looked at him.
Nobody knew it happened.
He could have walked.
I think the pitcher actually found out it happened as he was walking back up the mound. Morales just watched it happen. And Dietz knocks this one between second baseman and first baseman. And that'll bring home Foot. So the Cougars add a run this inning.
And I think that we're going to get a new pitcher here soon. They're going to come to the plate and discuss. But, you know, Nolan Beck has just kind of had a tough time up there of, you know, getting hit by these Cougars. But, I mean, they're just on fire right now. I don't think you can blame Nolan too much because he's throwing some good balls. It's just Union's playing really well today.
Yeah, they're going to bring Andrew Powell. He's a left-hander for the Patriots. Yes, he will. There's the. Shouldn't be too hard, but it is a little bit more difficult on those the lefties. You don't see that ball coming up over the top, but they will make a pitching change, and we're going to go to a break while he warms up.
At Basin I&E, we are an instrumentation and electrical company for the oil and gas industry. We also do commercial and residential work. We've been working in our local area for over 10 years, and we are proud to be part of the great communities of the Uinta Basin. Our journeyman electricians are fully licensed, bonded, and insured, and we offer high-quality work on every job. Let us come work for you, 435-789-9515, or visit our website at vernalhomeelectrical.com.
When you need windows, doors, bathroom glass, or paint, Jones Paint and Glass can help. With over 80 years in the industry, we're Utah's go-to expert for paint and glass. We offer beautiful, energy-efficient Jones Paint and Glass windows, as well as Anderson and Marvin windows and doors. We also offer top paints like Benjamin Moore and PPG Pittsburgh paints. Whether you're remodeling or building from scratch, Jones Paint and Glass has you covered.
And we are back here as Powell is our pitcher taking the mound for the Patriots. One out. And runners at the corners as Labrum.
Powell has one win and two losses this year at the pitcher's mound.
It comes in at a difficult situation here. You know, only one out. Runners at the corners, they're going to steal second. And no one's even going to attempt to stop Raiden from doing that. Here's your base.
Yeah, and they have a lot of stolen bases. I mean, Union has, before this game started, it was 40. I think they have three or four already in this game. So, and stolen bases for Providence Hall is, 14. So there's a glaring stat for you.
Yeah, Lincoln, real quick there with an 0-2 count. So Powell comes in, 0-2 count, one out. And Laborum will swing on this one. High, going to go right. I think the first baseman can get underneath this, and he just judges it wrong.
Yeah, good thing it stayed foul. I mean, it dropped right there in the middle. I don't know if they're losing it in the sun right there, but that's two plays.
That was high. Is this too high?
It might be too high.
Nate Foot knocked one. It was too high. They couldn't get it. It was too high. That one was high.
All right.
Depth perception just gets thrown off. Really?
Yeah.
I wouldn't have. Not when it goes high like that. I can't. Throws me off. Here comes Powell's pitch. High. It's too high. It's a 1-2 count here for Laborum. One out. Dietz out at second. And I can't remember who's on. Oh, that's Braden Evercore on
third.
Who's
on first?
Who's on third? And Laborum going to knock this one center field.
This one should be caught. It's right there.
It is going to be caught, and Nebraska will tag up. He's going to go ahead and score. And the Cougars up 8-0. So another run scored. That's to this inning. See if they can keep their average. They're doing three an inning. So let's keep that average with Roar up. East and Roar.
And
up to bat,
Powell's doing a pretty good job so far at the plate. I mean, he's got a cool delivery, kind of a sidearm lefty.
Well, fairly accurate, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, Roar will swing down that one. That one's going to we'll send that one out to the street. So here in the bottom of the third, and the Cougars lead 8-0. Over the Patriots. Powell. He'll lose this one. And Dietz will steal third. So this catcher, Rhett Wolfie, just a freshman. He's done a decent job with the pitchers, pitching into the dirt a few times. He's able to get in front of it. He'll lose one every now and again. But again, how much of that's the pitcher's fault?
Yeah, he's had a few wild pitches that,
How about that hit?
Whoa.
Roar knocking that one down the third base line.
Roar right
down. And he's
going to
go
line.
Second. He got it.
Wow.
A double, and he brings one home, and the Cougars will keep their three-run average per inning intact.
So many things have gone the way for the Cougars. I mean, that one just barely hits in the line of third and stays in and gets a double. I mean, so many different plays so far have just rolled the Cougars' way.
Up to bat number 18, Dace
and,
Wilcox.
And some days are not like that.
So the designated hitter, Dace Wilcox, up to bat for the Cougars with Roar at second. Powell's pitch comes across, strike one.
That was a really cool pitch. Curveball to the inside.
Yeah, it was an inside curveball.
A
curve
lot ball. Of movement on that one.
Yeah, hard to and that one, another one, and knocks it right at the pitcher. Roar's going to come in. The center fielder loses control of it, and Wilcox is going to go to second. And they bring in another run, and so the Cougars up 10-0 here in the bottom of the third.
You can just see the Cougars, they're rolling. I mean, they've won their last six in a row, and they're playing really well. They're peaking in a great moment, a month away from.
Just not too much trouble here against the Patriots. As Zach Foote, number 5 on the batting order. That one way outside there. Looked like maybe he just released it just a little too early.
And then throws it right down the middle.
Oh. Go ball. That was a little high.
Wow, that looked close.
Yeah, I'll agree with you. So a 2-0 count here. And swing and a miss. 2-1 count. Two outs. Dace Wilcox at second. And that one way outside. And that'll give Wilcox an easy steal to third.
They've had quite a few wild pitches to deal with and a lot of base runners on and moving, you know, from plate to plate. Those are costly and turn into runs, and that's why it's 10-0 right now.
Well, Foot with a 3-1 count here. Powell with the pitch. And ball four. Guess another high ball.
Yeah, it's
hard to tell.
High. I mean, yeah, we're at
it's
a
hard
tough
to tell.
View. You
You're
know,
above them.
Right there, but that looked close enough for me to call a strike.
Yeah. Let's hear it. Let's hear it when you're down there, okay? That gives Foot a base, and so we got runners at the corners and Hyder up to bat.
Up to bat, 24, Caden Hyder.
Hyder, a senior for the Cougars, and he's going to get a hold of this one.
Let's
this
see
one.
If they can redeem
was it too high
on
again?
One.
Too high.
That one's
too high.
Short and high.
Too high.
That one they had to run pretty far to get, so. Okay, it's foul.
What stats you got on Hyder this year?
Caden Hyder, he's a 321 average, two doubles on the year. Just he's like that clutch guy, you know, whenever you need a really big play, Caden Hyder comes up with it.
Not much necessarily needed here, I'm going to say.
Yeah, and he's a fast guy. I mean, they have a lot of fast guys like Raiden Dietz and then, you know, Caden Hyder, and you remember in football when we were calling this team, Caden Hyder was their, like, slot receiver guy when they needed a big play around that end.
Yeah.
They needed Raiden Dietz to run it around the end or Caden Hyder to get, like, a screen pass right around the end or a bubble screen.
And Foot's going to steal second. Steal after steal. And, you know, and Wolfie doesn't bother to make that throw. If he knows he can't make it, he just lets him go. No reason to try and really mess things up by throwing it and they come in as Hyder will swing on this one.
And both those situations, they had a guy on third, so
they just
scared to make that play. You know, don't want another score.
You know what? No big deal. Yeah. He's gonna get to second anyway. So it's just make sure someone doesn't come home. And Wolfie's done a good job.
And there. There's two outs. You know, he's just one out away here.
As Hyder knocks this one, it's gonna go right field. Oh,
he had to adjust at the last second, but he made it.
About came up too far out as they do retire the runner. And so after three innings, our score is Cougars 10, Patriots 0. We're back after this quick break.
We are the people behind the connection. You may never see us, but you are always on our minds. Because you are the reason we do what we do. Improving the way you connect is the reason we are always working. Why we are always building. Why we are always striving to give you the best. We are the people behind the connection, working together to connect your life.
And we're back here live at Union in Roosevelt. Brandon Jones and Mark Winterton watching some baseball. How about it?
Ah, it's great. Top of the fourth inning. Wild pitch there by Lincoln. That has been very unusual. But it was great vision there by Gurr, able to get a hold of it. Now, I can't believe that one didn't hit Evans.
Yeah, that was going towards the head, man. Got out of the way real fast.
Oh,
inside
another.
Again. Chin music.
Evans had to get out of the way of that one. You know, take the hit and get on base. Kind of like, what are you doing here, Labrum? He's got a 3-0 count real quick.
Yeah, right now he's got a no-hitter. He's got to, you know, make sure that this – well, I guess if you walk him, it's still a no-hitter, ain't it?
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Yeah. I'm still talking no-hitter. I know it's early. I know that there's all those superstitions, but Lincoln's got it, man. He's got it going on.
There's another one, and that'll give Gentry Evans a base. So first on for the Patriots
here. For the day.
Yeah, for the day for the Patriots. First on here on a walk. Yeah, starting fresh here now.
Number 11, Nolan B.
With Nolan Boynton, right? No, Nolan Beck, sorry. This is Beck. This is the pitcher.
Yeah. And Beck, I mean, he's got a 417 average, so he hits the ball really well. One triple, one double. So now he can just focus on hitting.
Yeah, he's not pitching anymore. Powell came and relieved him.
You got a guy on. You know, make a run here.
Swing and a miss. Well, he hits. He pitches right, but bats left.
I haven't really kept track of where he hit last time. Is he a switch hitter or is he shoot? I mean, that's pretty impressive.
I don't know. As Evans really dives in, foot trips over him. And so zero outs here in the top of the fourth. Again, the Cougars on top, 10-0. It's foul ball. So where are we at? 48 pitches for Labrum?
For Labrum, yeah. That's not very many at all. I mean, he's got 7 strikeouts, throwing the fastball really well. That last pitch, I'll say, though, that Nolan Beck was so close to hitting that one. I mean, it just a little bit late. Swing a little earlier, and there he gets it.
Right in Easton's chest, and he does get it to the second baseman there. They get the out. But that is the first hit of the game for the
Patriots?
Patriots.
It's tough to say that word, you know, if you don't like New England. I understand.
I just had a, it was like a brain aneurysm something. Oh, this is Evans here. Who was I calling Evans before? That was Ben Morales. That was Morales that I was calling Evans. Now Evans is up. Totally. But Morales is the one that just got out there at second.
So Beck spoils the no-hit early.
Labrum going for the pick there.
But we're talking about averages, you know. Nolan Beck had a 417, and not too far down is Gentry Evans with 406. I mean, that's really good.
Yeah, swing and a miss. Strike two. So Evans now with an 0-2 count on him. With one out here in the top of the fourth, the Cougars on top 10-0. As Labrum will take a look at his runner at first, and now here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss. He strikes him out. That's 8 strikeouts?
That's 8 strikeouts for Lincoln Labrum. And right there was a little sinker ball. I mean, it looked like it was in the strike zone, and then it hit almost the plate, just dropped off the table right at the very end.
Number 23, Taylor M.
52 pitches here in 4 innings with 2 outs. Yeah, this one going to go to Dietz there at center field. Dietz is there. He can't make the catch. And the Patriots are going to come in. Here comes Beck. He'll score one.
So the crazy thing about that, you know, Dietz was playing short right there. He was playing the infield just a little bit, and he still almost made that grab. That's how much space he had to cover before he could catch that, and it just went off his mitt so close. But you could just, man, I'm just in awe with Raiden Dietz's speed as a sophomore.
Well, what a great hit there by Taylor Marshall for the Patriots. It is now Josh Boynton is our next up at bat inside.
And they got someone home on that play, so it's 10-1.
Gurr wants to talk with his pitcher here.
Just a little bit of a interview here at the plate with the catcher and pitcher. He's been doing such a great job. He's just saying, hey, like, man, hey, let's do it like we did in the last couple innings.
Hey, he's up. You got this.
You got it.
You got this. No worries, man. No worries.
But an important score for the Patriots.
And he's going to knock this one right field. Nebaker makes the catch. And that'll end the inning as the Cougars still lead 10-1. At the after, I guess, the top of the fourth there.
And the Patriots getting a run on that one. That was a big inning for them. And they're starting to maybe see a little bit what Labrum's doing. And like they got some contact on a lot of those bats.
Well, big thanks to our sponsors again. L&L Motor proudly serving the entire Unibasin by offering unsurpassed customer service along with the largest selection of new and used vehicles all under one name. That's L&L Motor. Yes, Powell warming up there out on the mound. Also, Jones Paint and Glass. Whether building a new home or remodeling, Jones Paint and Glass can help you create the home you've always wanted with new windows, doors, paint, and so much more. Jones Paint and Glass, another one of our sponsors here of high school sports in the Uinta Basin. Again, you're enjoying the Cougars taking on the Providence Hall Patriots in this baseball game. Moon Lake Electric, proud sponsor of high school sports here in the Unibasin. Moon Lake Electric.
Yeah, man, let's talk a little bit about the Jazz. You know, last night got the win at home finally. Really should be 2-2 in this series. They choked, you know, that game at home, the first one there.
Game three.
And game three.
They did.
Yeah, and no team has came up from a 3-0 deficit. And would it be a year if Utah did it?
It would be history is what it would be.
It would be awesome. And it would put Donovan Mitchell finally in that category with, like, Stockton and Malone.
But can they win in Houston? They got demoralized in game one and two.
Yeah.
Just.
You look at NCAA basketball, you know, you can't lose. You know, you have to get all the way to the end. So, you know, just play with that mentality. You can't lose. And to win a championship, the only problem is you got to play Duke three times in a row.
Yeah, basically. That's kind of what it's – Harden's been tough. But and, yeah, even in game three where he didn't hit a shot until, like, late in the third, and Jazz still couldn't get it done. 2-1 count here. On foot, Powell's pitch comes in. It looked like it was another breaking ball, but it was too high. And so that's going to give Foot a 3-1 count.
Yeah, that just crawled across the plate. I mean,
it kind of did, didn't it?
Low 60s.
Here comes Powell's pitch, and he's going to swing on this one. So now a full count on Foot. And there's a nice hit. He gets past second base. And so that'll put Foot on. That brings up Kobe Gurr. I like his music selection, by the way, there.
What was it?
It's the Killers.
Oh, that's right. We talked
Andy,
about that.
Andy, you're a star.
I like the Killers. They're a Utah music group.
Well, Gru's going to get a piece of that, and I'll put foot back at first.
We have all sorts of Utah music groups. Imagine Dragons. There's another one.
The Killers.
Neon Trees.
Neon Trees. I don't even know that one.
Come on.
Sorry, I have to
look it up. Punk realm, but it's not really my thing. But
Neon
I know.
Neon Trees. Okay, I'll have to go look it up.
Hey,
now.
You have David Archuleta. You told David me about Archuleta. Him like before the game. I was just listening to his new soundtrack.
David Archuleta is actually in Vernal tomorrow.
Is he really?
Yeah, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go to his concert.
I would go too, man. That guy's a stud, man.
I am. I'm going. I think it's sold. They're sold out.
Yeah, he's pretty awesome.
That pitch inside, get away from the catcher, and so Foot will go ahead and get a base. Another stolen base. Cougars are just having fun with that today. Gurr with a 1-1 count. Our pitcher, of course, is Powell. Andrew Powell. He is a senior for the Patriots. He's going to check his runner there. Second. Pitch comes crossed high. So it'll be ball two. Cougars needing another score. Get that mercy rule after five innings.
Yeah, they have a guy in scoring position. Did they put Gurr out again? Or
well, Gurr's going to go ball four all there. Right. And so Gurr will take first. Take his base. And we got Nemeker.
Well, Kid Rock step-up music for Braden Nemeker. Have we heard that one today already?
Yeah, we have. Three times. Three times.
Keaston Young pinch runs for Kobe Gurr on first base.
Yeah, Gurr comes over to get his catcher gear on, and they're going to steal. In fact, the steal from first to second there for Keaston was just a, hey, I'm just going to jog over here. Don't worry about throwing it. And Wolfie's like, yeah, I'm not going to. Don't worry. I'm just going to give it to the pitcher.
Yeah, they've let them have that all day. I don't know why.
Yeah, they haven't gotten real excited about it at all. So.
And you watch, like, the catcher, he can throw it, you know, a pretty good ball to second base. So, I mean,
my guess is there have been some overthrows or something that just haven't ended well. Coach decided, you know what, just hang on to it and don't even worry about it. If they want to steal second, let them. So a 3-0 count now here on Nemeker. And Nemeker will take his base. So Powell pitching him. They're coming in high. And, of course, it's that left-handed to the left-handed. And
right.
maybe that screwed a little bit with Powell. Powell just couldn't quite get him where he wanted.
Yeah, this is a little bit better matchup right here, left-handed to right.
So first baseman wants to come over and talk a little bit to his pitcher. That's Taylor Marshall who got the he's the one that got another hit on the Cougars, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
That one comes across.
And Raiden Dietz, he's been 2-for-3 today.
No bases loaded with no outs.
Yeah, this is your dream right here. You have three guys on, it's juiced. Yeah, haven't had a home run yet this year for Raiden Dietz. Why not right now?
Raiden's got the speed to get an inside the ballpark home run, so.
Yeah.
He's going to clip this one. It's going to go behind us and give him a 2-1 count. Here's Powell's delivery. Outside, ball three. He may bring the run home just with a pitch.
Yeah, right now you just got to throw this across the plate and keep alive, that's danger zone and really
and
Raiden's good news for
willing
Raiden.
To just wait. And he's going to take a shot at this one as the Morales can't come up with it. The shortstop causes this one go out to center, And that'll bring in two runs. Both Keyston Young and Nate Foote come across. So two RBIs there for Dietz. As now we've got Lincoln Labrum.
Up to bat, number two, Lincoln Labrum.
Going through the batting order for the fourth time here.
And we're in the fourth.
Yeah, that's about right. Cougars lead 12-1 here against the Providence Hall Patriots.
Yeah, you know it's a good day in batting if you can get through your lineup four times in the fourth inning. So your lineup an inning.
Well, Wolfie did make a throw there to first on that one.
He's definitely got the arm to do it.
Ball one. Bottom of the fourth here. Labrum, ball two, looks like. Oh, what do we have?
It called a balk.
Balk?
Yeah. He came off that square up there and get a freebie.
I missed it. He must have come off of it before the pitch.
Yeah, he was never even connected to it. So that's why they called it. Because he still got the pitch off it.
Yeah, because I'm like, wait, he pitched it. What? So he didn't step. And they're going to call a strike there. Labrum held back. But now a 2-1 count here on Labrum. Here comes Powell's pitch. Ball three.
Yeah, now almost football and basketball's over. It's all into Major League Baseball and high school baseball and college baseball.
Swing and a miss there. Full count on Labrum.
My team's the Braves. They look a lot like this Patriots, you know, blue and red team.
Yeah.
But, Braves are playing well. Rockies are playing well. That would look high.
I thought we had a 3-2 count, didn't we? Maybe we were just a 2-2 count. Now we're a 3-2 count. We had twos there. And there's your walk.
So
that'll load bases with Roar up. And no outs.
No outs. That's hurtful. I mean,
that's rough.
So hard when you're on the pitcher's mound. There's zero outs. Bases loaded. You know, baseball is such a mental game, too. So, like, any type of little thing like that gets in your head.
So that's going to bring out Carter Arnold is going to come in to a pinch run for Labrum. Carter with a broken wrist, and so he hasn't played a whole lot, but there's the catch. They make that throw to home.
He
dropped
it.
I mean, he drops the ball. And so Roar gets on base, and the runner coming home is able to make it as Wolfie. He was on the plate, too.
Yeah, he was right there. Just the ball didn't come to him.
We're going to watch this replay. There's the throw. And he's on the plate, but he loses the ball. And so Nebaker scores another one. The Cougars up 13-1 here against the Patriots with runners. Full bases loaded here. First, second, and third. Runners at all bases. This is Dace Wilcox. Ball one. And Wilcox knocks this one to the outfield, and we'll get another runner in.
You know, I'm talking about baseball, how it's a rhythm sport. You know, when we first got here, the Patriots, they weren't even here yet. They got here a little bit late. They only had a little time out there to warm up, and just never really got into it.
So Zach Foote, as you hear the Gummy Bear song, we did get the story on that. It was something to do with DeCall being a lover of gummy bears. And so because of that.
That player picked.
He chose the Gummy Bear song for DeCall, for Coach DeCall.
In honor of his coach. I mean, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah. So a 1-0 count or a 2-0 count here on foot.
You know what?
Again, no outs.
You know what my favorite snack is?
Gum.
Chocolate cinnamon bears.
Oh, those are tasty.
I mean, they sell them at Walmart for like $3.97, and I go get like a bag every week.
You can get like a 5-pound bag from Costco for like $10.
Oh my! I mean, I have to go there.
It is a. It's. I don't even know how big. It's like 20-pound bag.
I don't need that. I guess. But.
It's so big. It's just massive. Mm-hmm. It's like one that you have to put over your shoulder. It's
that
so big.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah.
What's your favorite snack?
Chocolate covered gummy bears. I mean, cinnamon bears. Whatever. Those are good. No, I really do like the chocolate covered. Another one. Boy. And then, so Carter Arnold will come across and score this one. No problem. Cougars up 15-1, and this inning is starting to get out of hand. They scored 3 in the first, 3 in the second, 4 in the third, and now currently 5 in the fourth.
Up to bat. Yeah, and a lot of walks, you know, and a lot of plate walks to get a run.
Powell's pitch comes across strike one there on Hyder. Hyder watching, waiting.
Yeah, so everybody's getting a chance, you know, with the bases juiced. This is your time.
This is your time. Grand slam. What are you waiting for?
Okay, so it's not your time? It's your time.
What are you waiting for, guys? Grand slam opportunity. Everyone gets a shot today. No outs, Hyder. Here's Powell's pitch, and Hyder's going to swing on it right field. Right fielder is going to come underneath it, and they will tag up at second and at third and score. Roar comes across, and so another score puts them up 16-1. And so now no loaded bases for Foot as they come around again. Didn't Foot start this inning?
I believe so.
I think he did.
I think we have gone through the lineup. You know, Powell started out really good, and then, you know, this inning has just been awful for him. I mean,
no, it has
he's
not
a
been.
Good pitcher, but it's just not working out
it's,
right now.
It's not been his inning at all. That one coming in high. Runners at the corners. In fact, Brother is there at first, and he's going to steal. He'll get second easily. And so we've got Dace Wilcox at third. And Foot at second.
We haven't been keeping track of how many stolen bases there are, but we're almost in the double digits right now.
Yeah, 2-0 count here on Nate Foot. Here comes the pitch, and he's going to swing. So that's going to go foul, so we'll have a 2-1 count now.
And Lincoln Labrum still has 8 strikeouts. Is that what I have on here? 8. Pretty good day.
That is a pretty good day. I was just going to listen to the, yeah.
And so, you know, Powell is up to 59 pitches right now, and I don't even think.
Is he really that many pitches?
Yeah, and I don't think Lincoln Labrum's even that high. I think he might be a little higher than that, but not much.
Well, and Powell relieved his in the third, is he?
Yeah.
This is only his second inning, isn't it? Ooh. That's it. Strikeout for Powell on Foot. That's the second out for this inning.
And
that's the
first Union Cougar to strike out today.
And now Kobe Gurr.
Is that right?
Wow. Kobe Gurr.
No strikeouts till then.
Yeah. Yeah, not for Providence Hall.
Mm-hmm.
So two outs here in the bottom of the fourth. The Cougars leading 16-1. Gurr. Seeing these come in quick, two high balls. Got a 2-0 count here on Gurr. Runners at second and third in Wilcox and Foot. Powell's pitch coming in right down the strike zone. Gurr swings on it. Foul ball. Great weather, right?
It is. I mean, awesome weather. No better baseball weather than this right now.
Yeah, great weather.
And that was a good pitch by Powell. And I'm watching him at the plate, and every time he throws high, he's not taking that step long enough. And every time he takes that step long enough, it goes right down the middle or on that corner.
Swing and a miss, and he strikes him out.
Two strikeouts almost simultaneously.
Well, he ends that inning. That was brutal. A brutal one as the Cougars scored six against the Patriots. And so we got a 16-1 lead. Quick, as mentioned, of our sponsors, of course, because we enjoy all of our sponsors that give us the opportunity to bring you this live coverage of high school sports. The Ute Tribe. Ute Tribe is one of our sponsors of high school sports here in the Basin. The Ute Tribal Enterprises is the fastest growing tribally owned enterprises in the state of Utah with 9 operations. That's UTE. Pride itself in offering the very best products and services to their customers. You can enjoy cosmic bowling at Ute Lane's Family Fun Center, Ute Tribal Enterprises. And United, operated by SkyWest. Special thanks to United Airlines, operated by SkyWest, for sponsoring tonight's live coverage. United Airlines, operated by SkyWest, is committed to being the Basin's portal to an entire world of travel. United, operated by SkyWest. And Stewart's. Stewart's, that is Stewart's Marketplace. One of our sponsors for our live coverage here this afternoon is beautiful weather. Union Cougars leading here 16-1 against the Providence Hall Patriots.
Yeah, it makes me want to just go out there and play catch. I love playing catch. Just go out there throwing around, getting that arm warm.
You don't want to pitch 54 times.
I'll do it.
Yeah.
I wasn't a great hitter, but I was a really good pitcher. But I'm not a good hitter at all.
Wolfie, the freshman, swinging on the first one there, strike one. As Labrum will continue. Yeah, only 55 pitches today for Labrum.
Yeah, he's lower than Powell.
And Wolfie's going to get a hold of that one. Labrum gets to it, throws. And Wolfie will get on base.
Yeah, Wolfie makes his way to first base. That was a good one. I mean, I didn't even think he wasn't even sprinting that hard. He should have been, because that was a pretty close play. He might have pulled something there, so they put a pinch runner in.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Did he look like he come up?
It looked like he like kind of pulled that quad, and he looked like he was just limping there to first base, but he did get there.
Well, he's a bigger guy.
Yeah.
Wolfie's been playing catcher for the Patriots today. Number 10. This is Jaden Lopez. And he'll knock that one foul. So top of the fifth. And this is it.
Yeah. This is away for Union.
Yeah,
I
just realized that. You're going to try to pick off runner there.
Unless they can score 5 runs this inning, it will stop there.
Actually, they'd have to score 6. Trying to see who that designated runner is. I can't get a good look at his number. What is it?
Yeah, I don't see him either.
Pinch runner. Now, that one looked like it was right across the middle, but it must have been high. So a ball 2. 2-1 count here on Lopez. Oh, catches the corner there for strike number 2. We got a 2-2 count on Lopez. No outs. Here's Labrum's pitch. And Lopez is going to foul this one off to the right. There's Labrum's pitch. Strikes him out.
Number nine.
Number nine, wow. It was actually, it was number 10. Lopez was number 10. What are you talking about?
I'm saying nine strikeouts, yo.
Up to bat, number two,
Chase Marshall. He is our next batter here. With one out, Cougars lead 16-1. They're two outs from finishing this game.
I see Cougars in a double play depth right here, looking to finish it off with an exclamation mark. 6-4-3 double play, here it comes. Nope.
Yeah, this pitch number 65 is going to go behind us. Marshall fouling that one straight behind us. I did love when the foul came back and you did jump. That was great.
I think I've jumped
you
every
actually
time.
You actually dodged. I mean, you're like, hey, here it comes.
I've dodged like three or four times. I'm not.
There's a net.
There's
and
a net
glass
and glass I
between
guess.
Us. And he's going to knock this one. It's right to the shortstop. And there goes the double play.
Oh, so close.
Oh, can't. Fulfill the double.
Man, I almost called it. I had a 6-4-3 double play. Not quite there at first.
The pitch to Keyston Young just a little bit off. Keyston did a great job staying in front of the ball. But that one, yeah. Yeah. Two outs. We're so close to ending this one. In the meantime, do want to thank another one of our sponsors, too, PetroTech, American Oil for America, working hard in the Uinta Basin and returning the sands back to their natural state without the oil. PetroTech, one of our sponsors for this afternoon's game here in this high school coverage right here on Channel V6. Again, Channel V6, you can check out this game after the game. Just go to our YouTube channel or you can check it out on Roku. The Roku app actually has it. And check out all of our other games. Next coverage, that's going to do it for us. Another strikeout. Well, that was number 10.
10. Double-digit strikeout, that's a day, man.
Well, in five innings.
Yeah.
In five innings, nonetheless.
So even with all the hits you have out there on the field that Union Cougars were on fire, Lincoln Labrum is my player of the game.
Oh, yeah.
10 strikeouts.
Yeah, great game there for Labrum as the Cougars will win this one 16-1. We'll be back here next Tuesday, right? Next Tuesday, we'll be come watch, join Merlin and Brandon as they'll be broadcasting the Judge Memorial game here at Union. That's next Tuesday. Same time, same place.
Hopefully the same weather. I mean, this is all spectacular weather for a baseball game.
Great weather. So that's it. That'll do it for us today as the Cougars again win this one 16-1 over the Providence Hall Patriots. Thanks for joining us. Have a great afternoon. We'll be right back.